Today on Making It Home, I'm going to show you how I made this wireless desktop charging tray, these pencil cups, and this laptop stand, all out of solid surface material. I decided to do a little prototyping with some plywood before I cut into the solid surface material. This let me make sure that the laptop stand would work as I expected. I wanted to make a laptop stand that would have interlocking pieces, and I wanted it to hold the laptop in an open position or also hold it in a vertical closed position. I thought this would give me some great flexibility if I ever wanted to change the layout of my desktop. If you haven't used solid surface material in a CNC before, it machines really great. I did set up this carve to have tabs on all of the parts so that when I cut through the last little bit of the material, the piece wouldn't slide around. Later, I just used a flush trimming bit on the router to cut off those little bits of tab that were left over. Sitting quite right because of the tabs, they're not cut off all the way, but there we go. After flush trimming off the tabs, I used an 1/8 inch radius roundover bit on all of the edges. This gives all of the parts a really nice feel and removes all the 90 degree edges that can be kind of sharp to the touch. So in carving this organizational tray, the first thing I'm going to do, this is 1/2 inch thick material, I'm going to cut the recesses in the top. These are three openings that will just be 1/4 inch deep, just to throw various items, paper clips, whatever you want. And then I'm going to flip this piece over, and then I'm going to carve the recess for the wireless charger. Next, I started carving the wireless charging tray by carving the different recesses in the top. I used a bowl bit for this operation so that the inside of the tray had a small radius to it. Once the top was completed, I flipped the piece over and carved the recess for the charging puck. As you can see, the solid surface material carves and gives you really crisp edges. Okay, so this should fit right down in here. Oh yeah. Charging. The only thing left to do is to go through and remove all of the tabs on the piece and then do some sanding. Using these smaller diameter sanding discs that fit in a drill worked really well for the recessed tray areas. So now they have the charging trays all sanded down, they're nice and smooth. The only thing really left to do is put the charging disc in the bottom. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut 4 little slots around that recess, and that way I can use some hot glue and kind of embed the glue into those slots, and that'll hold the charging disc in place. That way if it ever breaks or stops working for some reason, we can heat that glue up and take it out and then put another one back in its place. Next, it was time to get started on the matching pencil cups. I set the table saw blade at 30 degrees so that all the miters were properly cut. The pencil cups were made out of 1/4 inch thick solid surface material. This does cut very nice on the table saw, but it does dull the blades fairly fast. First, I cut a bunch of the 1/4 inch thick material to a uniform width. Then I used my table saw, crosscut sled, and cut them to the same length. Making something like these pencil cups is fairly easy if you cut the edges to the right angle. To glue the 6 sides together, all you do is stick these down to some pieces of blue painter's tape that has a sticky side up. Then just add your adhesive to all the joints. In my case, I'm using epoxy. Then just pick up both ends of all the pieces and roll them into a hexagon shape. At this point, they should stay together fairly well, but you can always add more tape around the outside of the cup. Not too bad. Now that we have a 6-sided shape, we need to cut a bottom for this pencil cup. I just set the cup down on another piece of 1/4 inch thick material and then trace the outline with a pencil. To make sure that all the parts matched up better, I actually labeled each cup and each bottom that I traced to make sure that they were a closer match. Once I cut all these shapes to the right size on the bandsaw, I fine-tune these with the belt sander. In order to epoxy the bottoms into the cups, I actually just put epoxy around the base and then slid the cup down over the top. Once the epoxy cured, it was time for some sanding and cleanup. As you can see, this desk was completely out of control. To start the overhaul on the desk, I actually just removed most of the items with the exception of some of the computer equipment and the monitors. The monitor stand I got for my desk actually had 2 different mounting options. You could either clamp it to the edge of the desk or put a bolt through the desktop in order to hold the post in place. In my case, I didn't have enough edge of desk to clamp to, so I had to drill a hole. With the monitors taken care of, it was finally time to bring in the laptop stand and the charging tray. I love how the laptop stand almost lines up the bottom edge of the laptop monitor and the other 2 monitors. I'm really excited about the flexibility the new laptop stand and charging tray are going to give me. As you can see, this is a huge improvement on the space on the desktop and gives me much more work area. So one of the other things I can do with this laptop stand is I can actually put it in a vertical position with it closed. So I'll show you how that works here. Some extra charging cables. So to do that, we just redo the orientation here. Thank you. So now we have it like this, and we can just slip the computer in like that. Now, if we only want to use the big monitors, we have this out of the way. It's held in place, and we have extra desk space. We slide that where we want, move it out of the way, and have that option. Thanks for following along in the video today. The wireless charging tray, the pencil cups, and the laptop stand are gonna make a big difference in the organization of my desk here. And the laptop stand gets the laptop monitor up even with the other monitors that I just put on the stand. So it's gonna make a big difference in workflow and having everything at eye level. Make sure you follow along. We've got lots of great videos coming up, and you can check out some of the older videos as well. Thanks for watching.